Very good morning, students. Last class, we have completed up to the digital thermometer. Today, I am going to discuss about scales of thermometers. We have three important scales to measure the thermometer temperature, such as Celsius scale, Fahrenheit scale, and then Kelvin scale. So let me explain about Celsius scale briefly. The picture shows the Celsius scale. Celsius is the common unit of measuring temperature, termed after Swedish astronomer Anders Celsius in 1742. Before that, it was known as centigrade as thermometers. Using this scale are calibrated from freezing point of water starts from 0 degree Celsius. The readings calibrated from freezing point to boiling point. So what is the freezing point of water? 0 degree Celsius. And what is the boiling point of water? 100 degree Celsius. In Greek, centium means 100 and grades means steps. So both words make it centigrade, and later it is called by Celsius. I hope you are understood, students. So Celsius scale. So how many divisions we have? It starts from 0 and it is end by 100 degree Celsius. So we will be having 100 divisions. So the picture shows that Celsius scale. Once again, so this picture also Celsius scale only. The reading starts from 0 and ends by 100. So starting point is, what is it? Water freezing point. Water freezing point, which is 0 degree Celsius. And what is the end point? Water boiling point. So boiling point of water is nothing but 100 degree Celsius. Next one is Fahrenheit scale. The picture shows that Fahrenheit scale. Fahrenheit is a common unit to measure human body temperature. It is termed after the name of a German physicist, Daniel Gabriel Fahrenheit. Freezing point of water is taken as 30 degree F and boiling point 212 degree F. In Celsius scale, freezing point, which is taken by 0 degree Celsius, but in Fahrenheit scale started from 32 degree F and boiling point 212 degree F. Thermometers with the Fahrenheit scales are calibrated from 32 degree F to 212 degree F. Celsius scale we are using to measure the weather temperature. We can measure with the help of the Celsius scale. But Fahrenheit scale we are using in the clinical purpose. In the hospital we are using to check the body temperature. Next one is Kelvin scale. The picture shows that Kelvin scale. Kelvin scale is termed after Lord Kelvin. It is the SI unit of measuring temperature and written as K, also known as absolute scale. As it starts from absolute zero temperature, which is 0 Kelvin. Kelvin scale is used in the laboratory. We know well, we are using three kinds of unit in the temperature scale, that is in the thermometer scales, such as degree Celsius, degree Fahrenheit, and then Kelvin. Degree symbol we have to use for Fahrenheit as well as Celsius, but degree symbol we should not use for Kelvin. So how to write? What I am telling you, know students, whatever the reading we are considering, for example, any one of the reading we can consider, which is 36 degree Celsius and then 98 degree F and then 100 Kelvin. Have you understood the difference, students? For the degree Celsius, for the Celsius and Fahrenheit, we have to use a symbol of degree, but Kelvin we should not use the degree symbol. That is degree Kelvin. We should not write this wrong way. But in case of Celsius, we have to compulsory, we have to use degree Celsius. Degree symbol we have to use for Fahrenheit as well as degree Celsius. And so here we can compare the three different scales, starting and end reading. First one is Fahrenheit scale, second one is Celsius scale, third one is Kelvin scale. So here also, so here we can compare the three different readings. Fahrenheit in terms of Celsius, Celsius in terms of Kelvin we can express. Actually, whatever the values we have, if you have the reading values in degree Celsius, the same value we can compare, I mean we can convert into Fahrenheit as well as Kelvin with the help of the formula. Look at the tabular column, students. We can start from here. See here, here consider the reading. First one reading is 212. The same 212 in terms of Celsius, 100. The same 212 in terms of Kelvin, 373. So this we can compare with the help of the formula. We have one formula. We can compare. And let me consider the another value. Consider here, students. 68 reading in terms of Fahrenheit. The same 68 reading in terms of Celsius is 20. The same 68 reading in terms of Kelvin is 293. And consider this reading. I mean, the starting reading is 32. That is Fahrenheit, in Fahrenheit 32. Celsius, the same 32 in Celsius is 0. The same 32 is in terms of Kelvin is 273. So like this we can compare. So how to compare? I told you now only we have one formula. So let me write the formula. Please listen, students. F minus 32 divided by 9 is equal to C by 5. This is one formula. And another formula is Kelvin is equal to 273 plus C. So this is another one formula. By help of this formula, we can convert the values. If we have the value in terms of Kelvin, we can in terms of Celsius, we can convert into Celsius. Or else, if we have the values in terms of Kelvin, we can convert into Celsius. So we can modify this formula. So if you wanted the readings in terms of Celsius, we can modify this formula as K minus 273. I hope you all understood, students. This is a formula I have to by heart. Thank you, students.